Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Planet Zoo and Oakwood. This is our genetics abnormality zoo or something. Basically a zoo where we play with modded animals. And today that means an orca, which is a whole other stage. You know, last time we had a bear, the bear was very cool. But this is an orca. This is something completely different, unseen of before in Planet Zoo. So credit to Nicholas Limerider who uploaded it and made it. Leaf for the dolphin coding, which this was originally based on, I believe, and Aurora Designs for making the model, and that was all the way back in, I believe, Zoo Tycoon 2. Aurora Designs was very well known for their Zoo Tycoon 2 mods and UI edits and stuff like that. So, what are we doing with our orca? Well, it is a controversial subject, let's be honest. Cetaceans in zoos, it's something that's been wiped out, generally speaking. People are doing it less and less and less because people believe that, you know, these animals simply can't be happy in a zoo environment. They just don't have the room to roam. So the first thing I really wanted to do was focus on at least giving them a gigantic tank. It's already humongous in terms of size dimensions to the side. It's already too big, really, for what I wanted to do. But in order to aid that, you know, we don't necessarily have to have it super, super wide, but at least give it lots and lots of depth. At the end of the day, it's still too small, and at the end of the day, I still don't think cetaceans should be in zoos. I don't think it's healthy for them, but I think this is as close as we can get, realistically. And I had a really weird inspiration for this. You're going to see this. So we've got the tank, and you're going to walk in front of it, sort of about the midway level. And my inspiration, oddly enough, was Godzilla King of the Monsters. When they go and they're looking at Ghidorah as he's frozen within the ice, and they're walking across all these sort of walkways and stuff like that. It's not like a heavy inspiration, but that just popped into my mind for some reason. I really liked the idea of walking along this gangway, and then, you know, to the side is just a wall, but you look to the right and this gigantic tank of water just takes up your entire vision, and you'd have the shadows in there of the orcas, and the orcas swimming around, and it'd be a little Godzilla-esque. I don't know, I kind of like the idea. So, built myself a big old tank. We can't just have tank walls, can't have muddy walls. We're going to use some of our lovely faux rock. We're going to use lots and lots of faux rock. Basically just building one slab, and then we're going to repeat that multiple times. We'll do some stuff later on to make it look more interesting, but, you know, if you're dealing with something so huge, and this is really the problem with big exhibits, is that it's very hard to do detail work because it would take 5 billion years. But we can do a little bit. And just going to sort of slather those around at the side. We did have to do a slightly awkward staggered opening that you can see here, just because obviously we do need a staff entrance, basically. And if I try to do it sort of flat from the top bit down to the very bottom of the tank, the drop was just way too sharp. The fence couldn't handle it. So what I did was stagger the dirt and stagger the fences down the dirt to sort of soften that gradient a little bit. It was a pain in the ass. It really was. So, adding the wall at the other side, I already kind of have a regret here in that the tank is a little bit too close to the path. I would have liked a gap on both sides, again, to kind of make it feel more like a gangway kind of thing, but, oh well. I can't move it now, it'd be madness. It would take far too bloody long, so. Yeah, again, this build is 2 hours or under, I think 1 hour 55 minutes. I will say it's probably not quite done. I could spend 4 hours doing detail work, but the point, as per usual, is to try to show what you can do in a couple of hours in the game. And then we ended up with something pretty cool by the end. Definitely needs a little bit more love, but pretty cool. I should mention very quickly, because I will get comments, Southeast Asian Zoo isn't over or anything. Those builds tend to take 4 to 5 hours, and I have been suffering a lot lately. I'm still in quite a lot of pain with this migraine and everything, and the tooth infection, and this whole week has been death for me. So sitting and recording for longer periods of time hasn't really been possible. Hell, I was going to not even do this today, so that's why it's been a little delayed. Hopefully we'll get back to that this week with our binturongs or something. Anyways, so that's our little walkway, just making sure that you can keep on filling the tank up. And that is about it. Like, for viewing areas, that is all we're going to really do for now. I think we may do a follow-up episode, maybe we'll even live stream it here on YouTube. I'd like to build like a side viewing area and do some more detail work, so we might do that on a stream. But I wanted some stuff. The problem with these really big tanks, again, is detail work. It's hard to add and sort of still make it feel natural. So I was looking online for other orca exhibits and orca natural habitats. And we're not going for the sort of the frozen north kind of angle. This is me Googling right now, by the way. We're going more for a slightly, I don't say tropical, but it's got a taiga, grassland, kind of vibe. Orcas are, I can't remember the term, but there's a specific term for them and other animals like it, in that they don't really have a set habitat, in that they cover most of the planet, basically. You know, if the habitat is suitable, they'll go live there. You know, they're not contained. I researched it for one of my Jurassic World Evolution videos. I can't remember the name. So anyways, the point was, they can suit like a very wide variety of environments, and I wanted something that would suit the penguin environment we already have a little bit more, because of course this is another aquatic exhibit. They kind of all meld together. So the idea is, it's kind of like a bay, kind of like a Free Willy kind of situation a little bit. Loved that film when I was a kid. We're going to have a little island on the left, and then on the right and on the back bit, so you can see these bits of land sort of poking in, it's going to be like staggered bits of rock with lots of foliage. You know, we're talking cold forest trees, I guess is the best word I can think of to describe it. And before we get further into the video, I should say, as brilliant as the orca is, it's really cool to see it in game. It looks beautiful when it's swimming underwater. It is based, I believe, on the otter. And every now and then, basically, whenever they go to the surface, they look super weird. They will swim on the surface and do this weird boppy thing. It's all very odd. You know, they're dealing with a lot of limitations. The fact that they got a working orca in the game is incredible, and the mod makers, Nicholas and Leaf in particular, who often lead the charge for Planet Zoo, for Planet Zoo modding, deserve all the respect and love in the world, so definitely go give them some. I will link the mod down below. And Aurora for the original model. I've used Aurora's mods for like a decade, probably two decades or whatever. Aurora's stuff started popping up initially. So we're going to have a lot of spruces, a lot of firs, a lot of beech, I think. I don't know. The point is, rock, sand, grass, hardy trees, all kind of coalescing into a bay kind of thing. Does that make sense? That's kind of the vibe I'm going for anyway. It is quite a big exhibit, which is a problem. You know, the penguins took 2 hours and this took 2 hours, and this is about seven times the size. So I tried to do this quite speedily. I was like, shum, shum, shum. You know, that's an accurate description of what I was doing. But, it worked out okay. So yeah, just staggering some trees on. It was getting a little iffy. Pouring some more grass. It was originally, the plan was to go very, very sandy, but a little bit of grass, just this sort of nice mix of materials, keeps the ground a little bit more interesting. Using the flatten tool a lot to add a little bit of intrigue to the rock itself. I really wanted the area around the islands and these like injunction, that's not the word, these inlets, these little bits of land jutting into the exhibit to be quite interesting to look at, or at least have stuff going on with rocks and plants and stuff like that. Shut up, world. Just because the actual exhibit itself was going to be kept very, very simple. I didn't want to load the exhibit in the way that we did, say, the Cayman habitat back in... Cayman? Gharial habitat back in our Southeast Asian Zoo. I wanted it to be a lot more plain in there, to an extent, I guess. I also ran into a problem, which we'll see later on, in that big tanks are really hard to light up. But we'll get there. So, just adding more and more plant life, as you can see. I've got to bring in some reeds. I really struggle with reeds. Like, they can look perfectly natural, sort of, but I don't really like how they look unless they're sticking in something. Basically, there has to be rocks jutting inside the reeds, or I get upset. Basically, I just don't think it works. There you go. So stuff like that, you know, the rocks sort of jutting out a little bit, and the reeds kind of tangle around them and gather up and grow around the rock. You know my love for putting plants around rock life, well, rocks, plants around. Plant life around rocks, bloody Nora. It's very early, it's like 8 a.m. You know my love for doing that anyway. The reeds in particular just kind of fits, you know, I don't know. I did make a slightly odd choice here. I'm building this entire habitat from one perspective, and that's from this perspective above the tunnel. But if we do a viewing area, if we do a stream and we do a viewing area and some more detail work, it's going to be on this right hand side. I left a gap specifically so we could build a viewing area for the orcas. And I haven't built from that viewpoint at all, so we'll have to do a little bit of tidying up, I'm sure. I always like to have one main camera angle that I'm working from to try to build things, but then you come to the other camera angle and everything looks like a disaster, so you do have to, it's okay. So yeah, I don't know what I'm going to build there, but something. That'll be cool. Things are cool. And this whole thing is gigantic, so it does link in sort of with the bears. That's going to link together in a unnatural way, but the idea is all the parts of the build are going to link together anyway. All the different parts of the zoo will eventually link in and tie and segue into one another. So yeah, messing around with the new water tool, which is very cool. It's just super helpful being able to control the transparency and the colour and how many plankton are there and whether, you know, Cthulhu is sitting at the bottom. I have resisted adding any more old gods to my exhibits ever since the aquatic zoo. Wanted to do a little bit of detail work on the bottom. The roughen tool is a tool that I very, very rarely use, but if you've got like a sea floor or something and you want to give it a little bit of intrigue and make it look a little bit more exciting, the roughen tool is actually pretty cool. It's very quick and easy, and it's not, you know, exceptionally detailed work, but you just kind of go ga-ga-ga-ga-ga, and the ground goes you know what I mean? So just chucking some rocks in there, chucking some plants in there. You're really not going to see much of this at all, but you can't just have like a barren seafloor. You have to have a little something going on there. Likewise, the walls, I'm not too worried about, because again, when this is filled with water, especially at nighttime, you're not going to see them. Now, I don't know why this is happening, really, because in the salt gharial Cayman. In the Gharial habitat we did in our last Southeast Asian exhibit, I used the spotlight and I used these little lights and they were really effective. Now this is a much bigger tank, but I'm not working with the further distance. I'm working very close to the screen, very close to the window. And for some reason, even the big area light, you saw me trying to use it at the start, it just gets washed out entirely. It doesn't make it through the glass. I've just realized why. I'm using thick glass instead of the thinner glass that I usually use, because I thought it looked more appropriate for like a marine park. That might be why. And if not, it's just because the tank is huge and that it kind of eats up light. Even though the lights are quite close to the screen, it doesn't matter. They're just being eaten up by the sheer volume in the tank, I guess. I don't know, it's one of those two. It might be the thick glass, though. We might have to try that out. Because I wanted some nice, you know, lights coming in, some world lights coming in. You know, keep it nice and bright. Make sure you can actually see the orcas, get some sun rays going on, make it nice and dramatic. But I just couldn't seem to do it. You know, the lighting is going to be very, very chill. I did come up with a little plan to fix it that we'll see later on in the video. But it isn't ideal, to say the least. Bringing in some of our fencing. Didn't realize it was twice the size it was meant to be. Didn't spend much time on this sort of surrounding area today, just general lights and stuff like that. Like I said, I was working with a fairly limited time frame and had quite a lot to do, so it is staggering what you can do in 2 hours. I'm not pretending this is like an exceptional build or anything, but we built a lot in a couple of hours. You know, it really didn't take that long, and it's pretty good. Yeah, it needs some detail work. The walls on the left need to be more interesting. We need some information signs and stuff like that, and the surrounding area is very boring, but there's going to be more exhibits there. I just wanted to make sure for the orcas that we had tons of room to play with, because again, I did want them to have a nice deep tank and quite a wide one, but mainly have that depth there. Not only for their happiness, but because I want you to walk along the gangway and look down and up and left and right, and it's just your world is encompassed by this orca tank, which I think is a cool idea. It is a cool idea. So, it's about now that I realised the fence was too tall, I think. No, not quite yet. Just linking those together. It's fair. No, now I realised, yes. It's about twice the height it should be. Have I realised? I'm probably Googling something. So I was going to build like a little decoration pit thing. You can't fill super short fences with water. I didn't really realise that. Just going to... I don't know. This is going to be like an information sign. I'm going to try to get like a little video of some orcas, and I have to convert that into a certain type of file, and I cannot for the life of me remember what that file is off the top of my head. But it's a certain type of file, a certain type of video file. So what I do is I just download those files from the interweb. Like, I'll find a video of orcas. That's about it. I'll find a video of orcas. I will bring it into Adobe Premiere, which is the video processing program I use, and I will convert the file into another file type, the one that Planet Zoo accepts. There we go. Got that eventually. So I'll get that done before we hop in game in a minute. And it's just like a little, you know, ooh, orcas, here's what you're going to see, isn't this exciting? And people walk past and go, ooh, orcas, isn't that exciting? The system works. So yeah, just building a little projection screen here. Not a lit up one, I picked the wrong one, so I'll fix that very soon. Doesn't say what type of file type it should be, nope. But yeah, trying to still keep things, like we're using different foliage and stuff. This is American temperate and taiga. The penguins are of course more tropical based, but by keeping the fence the same, by keeping the faux rocks the same, by keeping the lights the same, the idea is that even though these are from very different parts of the world and have very different foliage themes and stuff like that, we can make the entire area still feel interconnected and part of the same zoo. And the idea is eventually that will encompass the entire bloody map. I am trying to work my way towards the centre. We might do that on the stream as well and actually build the park entrance and the central area of the park and all that kind of jazz. Enough special, just sticks, basically, is all that we have there. 1645, good to know. I realised it was the wrong screen. Can't remember what I do for the rest of this video, if I'm totally honest with you folks. A lot of this was trying to sort the lights out. I do have fish feeders down there, and at the very least I wanted you to be able to see the fish feeder, so when the orcas swoop in, you'll be able to get a good look at them. We're going to bring the orcas in now, you're about to see them. It looks a little funky at first. You saw a little bit there of it bumping around on the ground, but when they get underwater, they do move very, very fast. They move, like, I had to keep checking that I wasn't on, like, times 4 speed, because they zoom around like absolute crazy. But the actual animation and the way they move looks really, really good. It's just a little bit quick. It's actually really, really cool. What I did there, you can see I'm about to sink these into the ground. I put tons of little spotlights on the base of the tank and sank that into the ground. The idea being that as the orcas swim by, at least moderately near the glass, they should be lit up from beneath. It won't be totally obvious. They're quite subtle lights, but hopefully you'll be able to see them a little bit easier, because they can get a little bit lost in the darkness, basically. Making that island look a bit more natural, not that you bloody see it. And yeah, that will be it. So I'm going to get the orca video going. We're going to hop in game. We'll just spend a little time with our orcas. I'll see you in a sec. Alright then folks, let's give this a go. So first things first, let's see if this little video is going to work. Orca video WebM. Yeah? Alright, that's pretty cool. I'm surprised, it's like a 2 minute long video, so I wasn't necessarily sure it was going to work in game. It was really hard to find good videos of orcas on YouTube, because every single bloody one of them... This needs a border or some description, I'm pretty sure. It looks a bit weird like that. Let me see if there's anything I can use. I like to use materials several times for fairly obvious reasons. What if we use the metal rods? That's a good idea, let's do that. Orcas are kind of like sharks in that people only seem interested in them in so much as that they kill things, right? And don't get me wrong, an orca is a fantastic predator. It really is. But, you know, they're beautiful, amazing creatures. They're so much more than crush, kill, destroy. And yet all the bloody videos on YouTube are precisely that theme. They are crush, kill, destroy. It's a bit of a shame, really. This doesn't need to be fancy, this. It needs something. Just going to move these slightly up as well. There we go. Yeah, there we go. There's our little orcas. We could put some text here. I think we probably should have like a little sign hanging down and the word orca somewhere in the actual thing. But that can be detailed work we do in the future. So there's our little entrance area. Like I say, I think we need maybe a sign on here as well saying the orca... Nothing rhymes with O. Well, nothing goes with O. What would my alliteration be? Orca Obis? And this will split off into another viewing area over here, and then that's going to tie in over there, and then this is going to eventually wrap around over there as well. So, they're all staying underwater, which is cool. Here it is from above ground. Let me just mess around with the time of day to get it perfect. You can see that they're very, very quick, but they're actually looking okay. Every now and again, they'll do something a little crazy, which I think is meant to be the otters lying on their back, but generally speaking they're pretty great. So yeah, I didn't want it to be overly fancy above. You can see we've got the sort of the land kind of moving in from here to here, sort of crossing over the boundaries of the tank, very much the goal. Yeah, nothing too complex. I need more trees over here, just decided. Like a baby tree. And you. Oh, not you, that's very weird. And you. Alright, let's get rid of line surface, which is the worst thing in the entire world. Sometimes line surface is super, super helpful. 9 times out of 10, however, I just never want to touch it, honestly. That'll look better. Yeah, anyways, right, let's hop underground. Check out the video again for a little bit. This was called, like, aggressive sexual mating behaviour, or weirdo behaviour or something. Because all the videos are, like, weirdly anti-orca, as I've said. It's very sad. Right, down we go. It doesn't look great in the daytime. It is very much a nighttime habitat. I saw every single habitat I ever built. Which just because it's such a... I mean, it's okay. Yeah, no, it's pretty cool in the daytime as well. I take it back. Yeah, aren't they fantastic? Again, big shout out to Leaf and Nicholas and Aurora. Because they just... They are very speedy. Meow. But they're pretty awesome. I wish I could slow down time. Let's swap over to nighttime. You can kind of see what I mean. So you should be able to see them quite often. I mean, it's still quite difficult to spot, it must be said. But we've got lots of lights in the ground, all hidden beneath the earth. We've got the food lit up here, although it hasn't activated in a very, very, very long time. Right, let's try to... There we go. When you get inside the habitat, it gets much better. They are fantastic looking. They really are beautiful. Hello, buddy. I mean, they're one of my favourite creatures, always have been, so... I do have a little bit of a soft spot for an orca. I was very excited to see this pop up on Nexus. But you can see what I mean by the light getting sort of drowned out. If we go in here, it's super bright around here, because there's another feeder over there, and I wanted it to be nice and shiny. But then you go in here, and it just gets womped out. Right, that's right. Womped out. Official term. I'm going to see if I can replace this, and if that makes a difference. But it doesn't, does it? It's very odd. It's very odd. I don't know what else to say. It's very unusual. Because this works on smaller habitats. I'll show you what I mean. So if we go into construction, we go into lights, and we grab our inanimate metal rod. If we grab our stadium light. Wait. Was I using the wrong light? I might have used the new world light, which is rubbish. Or the stadium light. Okay, can we see it? No. Sort of. Okay, maybe we can do this. Let's see if we can get some cool lights on. I'm going to attach it onto here. Alright, let's try to get a good angle. See what we can do, folks. Let's see what we can do. We might just have to... I mean, it just disappears, you know? I want the beam, the shaft of light to be visible. And for some reason, it just isn't. But it was in my last... exhibit, and I'm very confused. Just seems to... Like, in here, it looks really nice. You can see it, and it looks cool. And then... I don't know. Ah! I'm gonna hide you in there. We're gonna see what we can do anyway. Change the colour slightly. Just get a little bit of a blue tint on there. Yeah, and we're just gonna duplicate it a few times. I don't think this is going to work, but we're gonna try. I've lost it. It's gone. It's in there somewhere. Come back. Aha. Okay. Next step. It's getting you out of there temporarily. And what we're going to do is we're going to duplicate it many times. Or at least once. Thank you. Get that super intense looking. Grab all of them, move them back. Don't think this is going to work either, but we'll give it a go. Just disappears! It looks like in here, that's really cool. Well, it would be like in a better area, but there's no point if you can't see it from the blimmin'. From the other side. I'm a little disappointed. You can kind of get a sense for it. If it lights up and hits a wall. But it's not getting the sort of the shaft of light effect, which is what that's what I've been looking for, you know? Yeah, this is pointless. Oh well, it was worth a try. We got to do some building work in a video-ish. Either way, when you're actually inside the tank, they do look pretty cool. And even outside the tank. Oh, hello. So you can see what I mean by the gangway. I wish there was just more of a gap. I do want this to be a gap. And, oh, hello. Shadows. Oh, very cool. Hello. I did want this to be like to feel like a pit, at least slightly, like there's a gap there. And it sort of does, but I wish there was more space, just to really emphasize that feeling, you know? But they're beautiful. It's really cool being able to build an orca habitat. They do go a little crazy every now and again. I mean, this is fine. This is pretty natural behavior. Really like that. But every now and again, they'll just go extra crazy. Then again, I said that, and then as soon as I started recording, they decided to never ever do it. Because they hate me, and they want me to look stupid on YouTube. There we go, that's what I've been looking for. Generally speaking, if you just stick it underwater, they look really natural. Too quick, but other than that, perfect. And when they... Usually the time they look super fast is when they're going the wibbly-wobbly, you just saw it do it on the right. When they stop doing the wibbly-wobbly and they're just going straight forward like that, they look really cool, actually. Look at that shadow. That's terrifying. That's like horror movie stuff. Yeah, I don't have much else to add there, folks. I had a lot of fun with this. Come here, buddy. Oi, oi. Thank you. Orca cam! Da-da-da-da! Oh, isn't it pretty, though? It's pretty! Da-da-da-da. Nice way to view the habitat. So, let's swap this back to daytime. Don't know about the colour of the water. I might... it's pretty blue. Kind of look crazy there. But, yeah, so let's zoom out a little bit. So the idea will be we'll end up having another habitat here. There is another... There's, like, some really nice river dolphins. So we might do sort of, like, a double exhibit here with river dolphin and orca. I mean, orca's a dolphin as well, so, you know, it's quite a nice mix. But I've only got room, so maybe we do dolphins here, and then that kind of latches on there. We do something else here, and then that kind of leads on over here, and this is where the centre of the park is going to be eventually. Over here we have our burr, our burrs, plural, and our evil Russian metal bear. And again, that'll sort of lead on down here, and probably extend more to the right for this one, and lead on over there, and eventually it'll look like a thing, hopefully. I'm not really convinced at this point, but we'll see. Either way, thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. If you do like this orca, definitely go check it out on Nexus Mods. Really, really cool, really easy to install. Don't try to fly, we're not freewheeling it, okay? I love you though, I really do. And that's very cool. Thank you so much for joining me. If you enjoyed this video, please do throw me a like down below. I promise we'll try to get back to the Southeast Asia Zoo pretty soon, hopefully this week. And we'll go from there. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.